Starting with your 20th practical, that is crystal oscillator. Now, it is a linear electronic circuit that produces a sine wave output. The use of crystal oscillator in military and aerospace is to establish efficient modulation, also for navigation purpose, for electronic warfare, and in guidance systems. So, we will see how the crystal oscillator works and how it generates the frequency using CRO. A crystal oscillator gives more stable oscillations. You will be seeing the output on the CRO. It is widely used in microcontroller applications to provide clock signal. There are different types of piezoelectric resonators, but typically quartz crystal is in use in oscillator. So we use quartz crystal as the crystal. Selecting crystals for specific application will often be dependent upon factors such as size, performance, and cost. So crystals are available with the leads or without leads. This is the circuit diagram of the crystal oscillator, where we see there are capacitors, resistors, and this is the crystal used. So here the crystal is of 32 kilohertz. Let us see what are the resources used. We have a CRO, we have power supply, crystal, transistor, resistors, capacitors, breadboards, and connecting wires. So we will be seeing all this on the kit. These are the precautions to be followed. What you have to do is you have to build the circuit on the breadboard, but we already have a kit, so we will see how it is done on the kit. We will switch on the power supply, which is set to 12 volts. Then we will see switch on the CRO and we will see the output on the CRO. We will measure the amplitude and the time period on the CRO, and then we will calculate the frequency of by using formula F is equal to 1 by T. See, this is the kit of crystal oscillator. Here we have crystals Y1 and Y2. We have connected the crystals with the jumper. Okay. Here you have capacitors. This is the output capacitor, transistor T1, R2, R1. All this is connected internally according to the circuit diagram. This is your function generator, which is not connected. So we are not giving input to the crystal oscillator. And this is your CRO, where we will be seeing the output. See, there is no input given to the crystal oscillator, but since when I turn on the power supply, I will get oscillations on the output side. So this is because of the vibration of the crystals. This is the output connected to the oscillation. You can see the output. You can also measure the output of this. So if I connect the output over here, I get this way with the filtered C output. Okay. I can also connect the jumper to this crystal and look at the output. This is the output. You get the oscillation even without the input.